Hey guys, Dave here, Journey to the Outdoors. I know you're looking like, what the heck is he doing? Well, I'm going to make a video today on what you guys need as a bow hunter. This is what every bow hunter needs. This is my setup that I use. Actually, this suit is a ghillie suit, and I actually made this myself. It's pretty comfortable, pretty easy to make, and you know, it's just pretty effective. And one of the main things I say is a ghillie suit. That's what every bow hunter needs, because whether you're ground hunting or in a tree stand, you need to be concealed. Obviously, as you can see, I look like a gorilla, but but what goes through the bush more undetected than a gorilla? Maybe a lion, but I don't want to be one of those. You know, this suit is really effective. But I'm going to go ahead and show you guys today what you need as far as just being a bow hunter in general. And take this off. See how easy that comes off? And I'm ready to go, just like that. But I'm going to go ahead and show you guys. Basically, my bow setup, what I have is a Bear BTR. And it's a really great bow. You've seen me in this in the videos before. I've shot deer on it for a long time now. And it's just a good, steady bow. Most people think, yeah, why don't you just get a new bow? Well, you know, once you get comfortable with something where you're splitting arrows at 50 yards, that's a great thing. Why bother? Why go and get a faster bow or whatever? It doesn't make sense, but, you know, it's personal preference. I'm really comfortable with the bow. The bow is comfortable with me. We're getting married next month. You know, we've been engaged all this time, been killing deer. You know, I'm not going to mess with that. But my bow, I've done some customizations to it. I got a deer holder. This is actually deer skin on there. It's my strap for my holder. You know, it's great. So just the whole setup. Bow shoots really, really hard, really, really fast. It's shooting 75 pounds. On my arrows, what I really use is some nice carbon arrows. Now, it really depends on what I'm shooting. Now, you see my compound bow there, but also I shoot a recurve bow. And if I'm shooting my recurve bow, I'm shooting my aluminum arrows. And, you know, I do use that for preference. I mean, it's really a really good thing. You know, it's fast shooting with my, it's going to retain the weight that I need with my recurve. And, you know, it gives me a really good rigid arrow. So, you know, that's just a great thing. But with my compound bow, I'm shooting my carbon. And this is just really, really great because they're light. I can retain my speed, which is in the 300s. You know, and these arrows are just one of them. Actually, here is my go-tip. One of the best arrows you can buy. Really, really straight. This is one of the ones that I use to split arrows at 50, 60 yards, because it's like a 0.6. I think actually, yeah, this one is the 0.6. It's a GT Hunter, which is a great arrow. Try gold tips out. I'm not getting paid for that plugger either, but, you know, I just like to tell you guys what's a really great product and tell you what's effective to make you a better hunter. You know, as far as my broadheads, really great thing. One thing you really need to be is a very versatile hunter. You need to be very, very, very versatile to be able to adapt to the land or the property or the public property for that matter. If you're going into a new property and you'll be able to adapt to that, know what the deer need, know how the deer react, and you can adapt to that and then easily be a more successful hunter in a different area, out of your area code even. So that's just a great thing, and that's one thing that I practice at all times. So depending on what I'm shooting. Now, if I'm shooting a doe, I use the satellite arrows and the broad tips, and they're really great because they give you a lot of blood, yet, you know, there is like a little bit of play with them once you get out to maybe 40, 50 yards. So does, most of your cases, those are going to be in close for that matter. They're really inexpensive. You can get three of them for about $10, $11. That's really great. So I use those for my does. far as penetration, you probably lack a little bit of penetration, but they're good far as for close quarter shots. And I actually shot a buck with one of those arrows, and it didn't pass through. I had to shoot him two more times, and for that matter, he's on the wall though. but like I said, far as those, that's why I found out that I put that broadhead exclusively for those. Now, if I'm shooting my recurve, as I said before, if I'm shooting my recurve and I'm shooting my aluminum arrows, I'm gonna shoot a good heavy 125 arrow. Now, this is a 125 grain, and that's a thunderhead arrow, which is a really great sharp arrow. It's a big broadhead, got a lot of weight on it. It's gonna keep its retention. The recurve that I shoot is 50 pounds, so it's not too heavy that I can't draw in close quarters and be comfortable really slow. But it's gonna, because it's a low weight, I'm gonna retain a lot of my weight and my inertia to get a good pass through with my arrows. So that's why I'm saying you have to be versatile. Okay, now if I'm shooting a buck, there are several different broadheads that I would use. And one, the number one on top of my list, number one is going to be a Grim Reaper. This broadhead is beyond far, it's barred by none. Grim Reaper broadheads, man, I just believe in them. I've seen what they can do. Everybody think, oh, well, I want to get one of those Rage broadheads. I want to get one of those. Yes, they're fine. They look really good. They probably are effective. But here's the thing. When you, like I said before, when you get something that works, stay with it. Grim Reaper broadheads, I love them. This is another broadhead that I use also for, like, my crossbow. Got to be effective. You got to be versatile. As I said, crossbow. That's the third bow I'm shooting. Third bow is the Wasp. Wasp broadhead, really great. It's great for broadheads to be for crossbows, because it's got a small diameter, but it's going to retain a little bit of weight, so that way you're getting at fast speeds. This broadhead stands up. It's a really thick blade, so because of the weight that a crossbow can put out, it will still pass through without breaking your blades. You know, that saves you money. You know, you don't have to buy new blades every time. So also what I shoot, and this is just my backup broadheads that I'll keep in my box just in case anything happens. I have an extra broadhead once I get out there and feel, you know, for whatever reason. I can, you know, just have any problems with my broadheads, I can switch it out. I know this is going to be effective. This broadhead basically flies very well. It's a satellite mechanical, and it opens up. It's expandable. It has the rubber band there, but you know, it's very expendable, and it flies just like a field tip. Very, very, very effective. Moving on, I have my arm guard. I'm keeping this with me, you know, for my ghillie suit. I make sure when I put that on my ghillie suit, once I put it on, so I won't have anything catching in my string, stuff like that. And you know, it's just really effective. You need to get a hands-free call. You know, spend $5 at the end of the season. They mark them down really, really, really low, and you're ready for the following season and the following seasons to come. So, moving on. Actually, you can see my deer feeder here. It's pretty cool. Moving on. Far as releases, I choose several different types of releases, and you know, it's whatever makes you comfortable. Most people say, get one release and stick with that. Yes, but whatever makes you comfortable. And in this matter, I'm having several different releases for any type of given day. If I'm shooting my bow, my recurve bow, sometimes if I want to shoot my release, I keep one in the bag just in case something might happen where you have a cut on your finger and you can't shoot fingers. I'll end up using my release. And this release works with a string. It doesn't work directly with one of the string loops for the bow. So this goes straight onto the string. That's a different type of release. True fryer right there. Also, what I have, I live by it. I love 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 it. It's a, did I tell you I love it? It's a glove release, and it's so great because it spreads out the weight across your wrist when you're drawing. So therefore, you can be really effective at drawing easier and higher draw pound bulls. You can pull back easier because it disperses the weight differently from a strap release. So that just makes it more effective, makes it easier for you when you're out in the field. But this release, you know, it's really great. Costs $18 at Walmart. You can pick up one of those, try it out. Has a really smooth release, really smooth release. I don't have to worry about it. Now this is my release that I keep in my bag as a backup for any given reason that any one of these releases actually mess up. I have this release in my bag. I don't have to worry about it. I don't have to leave my stand and mess up my hunting because I've lost my release or dropped it or whatever, and you know I have to leave. I can go ahead, pull my release out of my bag. I have a second release. I'm not worried about it. Throw it on. I'm ready to hunt. I practice with this release also just for reasons like that. So, you know,